अस्सलाम वालेकुम, गुड मॉर्निंग। माय नेम इज राजा सलीम अख्तर। वेलकम इन दिस न्यू वीडियो। बिफोर टू वॉच द फर्दर वीडियो, सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल, लाइक द वीडियो, क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकन, शेयर द वीडियोस। जनरल थ्योरी ऑफ nth order linear equations. Here we shall study homogeneous linear differential equations of order n with real constants. A differential equation of the form a naught nth derivative dny over dxn plus a1 n minus 1th derivative dn minus 1 y over dxn minus 1 plus so on plus an minus 1 फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव डी वाई ओवर डी एक्स प्लस ए एन वाई इज इक्वल टू जीरो आर इन ऑपरेटर फॉर्म इट कैन बी रिटन एस आर इट कैन बी रिटन एस एफ ऑफ डी इन टू वाई इक्वल टू जीरो वेयर एफ ऑफ डी इज इक्वल टू वेयर ए नॉट कामा ए वन कामा सो वन कामा ए एन माइनस वन कामा ए एन आर रियल कॉन्स्टेंट्स इज कॉल्ड होमोजीनियस लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ ऑर्डर एन with real constants if a naught comma a one comma so on comma a n minus one comma a n are not real constants but are functions of x then it is called differential equation of order n with variable coefficients. Solution of homogeneous linear differential equations of order n with real constants. Suppose the given homogeneous linear differential equation of order n with real constants is of the form or it can be written in this form. Its characteristic or auxiliary equation is in this form. Note the equation 1 and equation 2. There are three cases for its roots. Case 1, when auxiliary equation has distinct real roots, let m1 comma m2 comma so on comma mn be n distinct real roots of equation 2. That is the auxiliary equation. Then the general solution of equation 1 is y is equal to c1 e to the m1x plus c2 e to the m2x plus so on plus cn e to the mnx. Note it and remember where c1 comma c2 so on comma cn are arbitrary constants. For example, if d is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma minus 4 that is distinct real roots. Here m1 is equal to 1, m2 is equal to 2, m3 is equal to 3, m4 is equal to minus 4. Then the general solution or fundamental solution is y is equal to c1 e to the x plus c2 e to the 2x plus c3 e to the 3x plus c4 e to the minus 4x. Case second, when the auxiliary equation has repeated real roots, if d is equal to m1 equal to m2 equal to so on equal to mn, m distinct roots equal to m, say, then general solution of equation 1 is y is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square plus so on plus cn xn minus 1 into e to the mx. Note it. For example, if d is equal to 2 comma 2 comma 2, then the general solution can be written as y is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square into e to the 2x. Note it. Case 3, complex roots. If d is equal to a plus minus iota b, then the general solution of equation 1, which is in this case linear homogeneous equation of order 2, then the general solution can be written as y is equal to e to the ax into c1 cos bx plus c2 sin bx. Note it and remember where c1 comma c2 are two arbitrary constants. For example, if d is equal to 2 plus minus 3 iota, then y is equal to e to the 2x into c1 cos 3x plus c2 sin. If d is equal to a plus minus iota b repeated k times, then the general solution of equation 1 is y is equal to a to the ax into c1 plus c2x plus c3x square plus so on plus ck xk minus 1 into cos bx plus ck plus 1 plus ck plus 2x plus so on plus c2k xk minus 1 into sin bx. Note it and remember Note miscellaneous roots. When the characteristic equation or auxiliary equation has roots of this form, for example, if d is equal to m1, m2, m3, distinct real roots, m4, 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 repeated roots, m5 plus minus iota, m6, complex roots, then the general solution can be written as y is equal to, in the case of distinct real roots, c1 e to the m1x plus c2 e to the m2x plus c3 e to the m3x plus, in the case of repeated roots, c4 plus c5x plus c6x square plus c7x cube plus c8x4 into e to the m4x plus, in the case of complex roots, e to the m5x into c9 cos m6x plus c10 sin m6x.